then see who's got the best car, and then we'll sort it out. Right now, it's still undecided.
How about the guys behind him? I'm pretty frustrated. The five car of Mears, and you saw Kevin Harvick in trouble.
We got Elliott Sadler. Sam Hornish involved in a little scrape here.
99, Elliott Sadler also involved. First caution flag of the day. Sam able to get his Dodge righted and headed back around and leading Rookie of the Year contender.
See, they race down into the corner. 77's already out of control there going into the corner. He loses even more control and gets into the side of Elliott Sadler. They both spin. I think Elliott actually got the worst of that.
I mean, you can just see how difficult it is to run side by side. That's why I was saying what a neat race it was when we saw the 99 and the 18 able to do this while under control. A little steam coming out of this one car now. He's overheating. I'd worry about this at this point of the race.
He will blend back in. Back with a restart here at Phoenix in just a moment. Under caution for the first time today, Carl Edwards trying to dodge bullets on the racetrack. Just dodged one on pit road. Watch the 77 car get nudged around, and there comes Carl trying to come out.
Yeah, close call on pit road. Very tight pit road here. So
he's moved up 17 positions. He started back in 31st spot, dropped back to 39th.
Whoa. Oh, my goodness.
Man, that was hard impact by Brian Vickers.
Hold it up there.
Just
going to
bring out the caution.
I'm not so sure that wasn't bad news for Jimmy to try to lead a lap. He was catching that two car.
Looks like turn three is going to be our trouble spot here today.
That was a hard lick.
It is a hard lick.
Show you what happened here on Brian Vickers. Top of your screen.
Man, the tire just came apart.
That's a tire.
The 11 is 6, and a lot of smoke now out of the 24 car. Jeff Gordon, who had been back on pit road.
Come on in, stop here either way.
They're telling him to get to the bottom of the racetrack. He didn't drop any oil.
Yeah, to hell with it. Just drive it to the garage. We're done.
Yeah, that'll do it.
Yeah, they've been working on that in the last caution. They were under hood a couple of different times.
Yeah, they were trying to see if it might be a plug wire or something. They did change the plug wire, but it was definitely internal.
He'll head to the garage area. This would be his sixth DNF or did not finish in 2008.
The sport, you're going to have some breaks. There are good breaks along the way.
I'll tell you what, though, Chad Knaus and the guys, even Jimmy, are probably thinking, man, these are going to be the longest. Whoa, there goes the five car around.
Yellow.
Whoa, and it gets hit. Ridges there. Yeah, the 97 of Ambrose. Look at this 28 car. Is that the 38 car? All jacked up in the back. Somebody's underneath him.
So much we can't even see who that is.
He's going to fire up the exhaust.
Had no choice.
That's the 84 of Scott Speed that he's up on the hood of.
He put it in gear trying to drive off, but. No traction.
He's got a Ford Fusion in his windshield and Speed able to climb out of the car.
That's what you call getting somebody jacked up, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. They put the red flag out right now. They're stopping the car short of all of this, which is a good idea to get it cleaned up because these basically are, these guys have their tires on for the last. They don't want to run them through this debris.
Watch the Montoya and the contact there with the five car of Mears.
Wow.
Just hard racing through that dog leg.
Yeah, Casey Mears' great day went south in a hurry.
And all these other guys see are getting involved here. Oh, Marcus Ambrose having a good run there. Looks like he got a piece of that.
Yep.
Got into the back of Riggs. 0-1 able to get through. Whoa. And then there's the contact with the 84, the 70, 38, 77 up against the wall.
70, you just got back onto the lead lap in the previous caution.
The second time today, they're going to have to pick that 38 car up and try to get it off the hood of Scott Speed's Toyota. Back in just a moment.
I'm going off the rails on a crazy train.
Back in just a moment.
I'm going off the rails on a crazy train. I'm going off the rails on a crazy train. I'm going off the rails on a crazy train.
But it was an air pressure adjustment that's helped Jeff Burton out on lap 261 on that pit stop. Jeff Burton said, I just can't hang with these guys. I have no clue. not drive with them, so they made an air pressure adjustment, and as you can see now, that 31 has certainly come alive.
There's a caution flag that Ray Evernham predicted would happen.
We could see the 18 and 41 get together. I was wondering which one of them might get the flat tire right there, and it didn't take long to find out. That splitter probably got against the left rear tire of Reed Sorensen.
It's hit pretty hard. He's forgot to come to you.
Watch him coming out of turn two here. You see Kyle Busch gets up into the side, and that right there is what more than likely would cut the tire down. Yeah, you can see it come apart right there.
Okay, here these leaders are going to come by pit road.
Now, what do you do, crew chief?
Well, I'm going to leave him out if I'm Chad Canal, just because of the track position.
If I've got a car like that 48, I'm staying out, Rusty.
The 48 might have to stay out. Well, I tell you what, if I'm Eric Dale Earnhardt Jr. Hamlin or somebody like that, man, I'm coming out.
Bonus points then, too, which hasn't been added yet for leading the most lap. Oh, I'm sorry. They've already been added in there. So that's 141, which still means he's got to, you know, he has to finish the race next week. He has to show up and he has to finish. He can't be, you know, he can't finish dead last. So that'll keep things interesting as we get there. But Carl Edwards is going to have to go down there and make a statement, too.
Four position on the racetrack, Andy. They've caught the nine car of Casey King.
He's got fresh tires now. It's making a difference.
See Mark Martin there, who's got the free pass.
Kevin Harvick steering hard on the bottom of the racetrack, trying to take the position away. That's sixth spot from Dale Earnhardt Jr.
Stewart around Kenza.
Allmendinger gets by. There's the seven car, Robbie Gordon involved.
And I couldn't help but think when you guys were talking about next week that this one wasn't over yet.
Caution number 10 on the night, or day, or whatever we are here in Phoenix.
It is getting dark. It's like Stewart's having trouble getting his car started.
Yeah, he had to be pushed off from that, from the red flag situation. That will put Tony Stewart a lap down.
Watch his contact again going into the corner. There's Allmendinger on the inside of Kenseth.
And there really wasn't any room on the inside of Kenseth right there. And A.J. was trying to make him.
There wasn't any to start with.
As is the case a lot of times, the guy that creates that contact drives on by these guys.
If he does it right.
And it wasn't something that A.J., he got tires on, he'd been in.
Yeah, he didn't do that on purpose. He was trying to make the most of what he had.
He just saw an opening and thought that he had a chance to get his nose.
Carl Edwards got a good job.
Jimmy Johnson laid the power down pretty good off of turn two.
Kurt Busch did all he could do right there.
Yeah.
It was right on him.
Jimmy Johnson will come out of four for the white flag here at Phoenix. One lap to go.
He's not driving hard.
He's still digging. He got that thing completely sideways.
Jimmy Johnson sideways there, too. Kurt got a nice run off the corner.
Okay, we're coming.
See if he can get to the bumper.
Can he get there? Here he comes. Kurt Busch. A car length away. Jimmy Johnson trying to hang on.
Car length back. Awesome job, dude.
And Jimmy Johnson wins for the seventh time this year. Whoa, contact.
For these cars. That's a bad way to end the race. A lot of cars getting torn up here.
Six, seven, eight cars involved.
Stewart's involved.
Robbie Gordon there. Bill Elliott involved. Kenny Schrader involved. The two initially involved were the 42 and 10. They were sort of shoved aside, but Jimmy Johnson pumping that fist and waving and saying, guys, we got one to go.
See Allmendinger battling off the corner here. I think that was 17 kind of moved down, saying he wasn't too happy about the last caution that AJ created in getting into the back of him.
Let's go down and visit with Chad Knaus, the winning crew chief. Mike.